Welcome to the Hour of Harvest. It is great to have you with us as we worship the Lord. Sit back and enjoy as we share the good news of the gospel. We invite you to participate along with us as we sing songs of praise, read the Bible, and pray for those in need. The Hour of Harvest prayer team is standing by to take your prayer requests, praise reports, and lead souls to the Lord. You may call us at 606-464-4250 at any time during this program. May this program be a place where you feel accepted, loved, forgiven, and encouraged in the Lord. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls with the unconditional love of Christ from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. From our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome into our service tonight. We have a good group with us that we're just going to have church. We're going to do our best to lift up the name of the Lord. And so we invite you to join in with us. We know from talking to many of you and from your letters and that there's many of you that join with us at night. Sorry about that. All right, we're going to read some scripture, and then we got some good singers here. We have good several phone operators. If you need to call, go ahead and do it. But tonight we're going to read from Psalms 105. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord and call upon his name. Make known his deeds among the people. In other words, tell what the Lord has done for us. Sing unto him. Sing psalms unto him. Talk ye of all of his wondrous works. Glory ye in his holy name. Let the heart of them rejoice that seek the Lord. Seek the Lord in his strength. Seek his face evermore. Remember his marvelous works that he hath done, his wonders and the judgment of his mouth. O ye seed of Abraham, ye servants, ye children of Jacob, his chosen, he is the Lord our God. His judgments are in the earth. He hath remembered his servants, his covenant forever, the word which he commanded to a thousand generations. The Lord is, he remembers what he has, the covenant that he has made with his people and to a thousand generations. So we don't have to worry about him forgetting what he has promised us, because he doesn't do that. And we are to tell about the great things that he has done for us. And so as we go into the service, that's what we do every night. We do our best to lift up his name. And so we want to do that tonight, and we want you to join with us. And we have some urgent prayer requests in already. We have just received word a short time ago that Dennis Lovins, that's Don's brother, passed away this afternoon at the UK hospital. He had COVID and a lot of complications. Funeral arrangements are incomplete at this time, but the family all really needs prayer. And that's the passing of Dennis Lovins from Clay County. And then we have from California, email with someone really sick and needing healing. And then also Joyce from Berea for her niece that's in the hospital today with pneumonia, COVID pneumonia, and heart and lung trouble. And then just shortly, an hour or so ago, one of our workers, his grandmother, Emily Estes, has taken a fall, and it might have been a stroke, and so they have gone to check on her, and so she needs prayer. So there's many others, and we want you to call if you need to, and let's hold up those that are hurting so much tonight, in need tonight. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for that covenant that you made for to thousands of generations. And we know that you've never broken a promise. Any word that you've ever given your people, you've always stood by it. You never get tired. You never forget what you have said to us. And so, Lord, we praise you tonight for salvation. We praise you that we have you to go to in times like this, in good times and in bad times. It's so wonderful to walk with you, and we thank you for that, because we know someday we're going to get to go home with you, a place where we'll never have another pain, nothing will ever upset us, or there'll be nothing wrong. Everything will be perfect. And so we thank you for our heavenly home tonight. We ask you to bless our guests, our phone operators. Lord, we're all here for one reason, and that is to lift up your name so that someone will take an interest. Someone will allow you to come into their heart and that they will be saved, even this night, in Jesus' name. Amen. All right. We're glad to have tonight the 11th Hour Ministry from Hazard, Kentucky, and their phone number is 606-439-4988. And of course, you know, you are well acquainted with these folk, and so you see them on a program here on WLJC all the time, but we have them here tonight, so they're here in person, and so that's what always makes it better. So right now, let's welcome the 11th Hour Ministry from Hazard, Kentucky.
Thank you so much, Sister Margaret, for the opportunity that we have to be here this evening, just to lift up the name of Jesus. And that's what we're all about. We just want to worship the Lord tonight and have church. This is a lot of folks' church. This is those that are sick and shut in, hospitals, nursing homes. This is their church. And so we're so honored to be able to come into your home, into your hospital room, wherever you're at this evening. We want to say something or just sing something that'll be a great blessing to you, because we believe that time is short, and I'm glad I'm one of them in that generation that he promised us blessings. Amen. 1,000 generations. Am I? And I'm telling you, I feel blessed a whole lot more than what I deserve. Amen. God's been good to me. And so we're just going to worship the Lord tonight, and we appreciate you for Sister Margaret for the opportunity once again to be here in such a wonderful station. And we tell everybody we can about it, how great this place is. It's winning the lost for Christ, and that's what it's all about. So let's just have church tonight. All right, Dad, won't you start us out tonight?
Out to my sister Berthy in Sayersville. Hope she enjoys her program tonight. Also, I'd like to send it out to my good friend Mike Steele, works up Cardinal Chevrolet in Hazard. Hope he enjoys her program tonight. Well, someday soon,
someday soon,
church I'm a leaving,
church I'm a leaving.
Yeah.
someday soon. I believe it's going to be real soon. I remember, and I guess I'll never forget, back when I was growing up, I believe, if I remember correctly, it was at the second toll gate exit there at Redbird. There was a church there on the bank, a long white church, and on the side of it, it said, "Jesus is coming soon." Amen. That was when I was a small boy, so that's been a long time ago. But I still believe tonight that he's coming real soon. Back then, we didn't have nothing like we've got going on in our world right now. I'm telling you, sin is on every hand. And we mentioned right before service, we was talking to Dad and my sister, and I said, you know, Apple's got out this new emoji for your iPhone. I guess it is with the Apple phone. It's a pregnant man. Dad said, well, that's a lie. Amen. Isn't that sad? But that's the shape that our world is in today. Amen. The Bible talked about a time they'd believe a lie and be damned. But I'm glad tonight I know the truth. And Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. No man can come unto the Father but by him. Do you know him tonight? Amen. That's what it's all about. That's what where real happiness comes from. It's when you know the Lord. And someday soon, we're going to be leaving here. Amen. And I want my sweet mama to sing tonight. And come on, Mom, just bless us tonight.
Well, I send this out to Sister Louise and Brother Tom and Dicey and my sister-in-law, Geneva's Fugit.
Oh, right.
thinking back around Thanksgiving and Christmas, Mom gave us a pretty bad scare. She has a real bad hernia in her stomach. She'd been operated on a couple of times, and she had a hole, actually two holes that came in her stomach, and they were coming to the outside of her body, and we got really scared and didn't know what was going to happen. But thank God she's doing better now. No surgeries as of yet, and we thank God for it. Those holes are actually healing up. Amen. And Mama, after a while, it'll all be over, woman. After a while, there'll be a day we don't have to worry about no sickness, no sorrow, no death, no pain. My. If that don't make you happy tonight, just thinking about a better time when we won't have no more troubles or heartaches, no more death. Hallelujah. Man, I'm looking forward to heaven. Hallelujah. I'm glad I know him tonight. I'm glad I met a man one day that took my sin away, wrote my name down in glory. Amen. Oh, my. We're about to have church in here tonight. Hallelujah. I want my sister Teresa to sing this song. She sung it the other day at church, first time I'd heard it. And, oh, it just blessed my heart. And it's a song about the woman at the well when Jesus came and to Samaria and he sat down on the well. Amen. Sing it, sis.
I heard a story from the Bible when I was just a little girl about a broken heart. Savior of the world, thought it was just another story, one that the preacher man would read. But I'm sitting here at home drinking red wine all alone. Cause tonight I feel guess maybe that's why grace is so amazing. Just like the story from the Bible I heard when I was just a girl. I'm that broken-hearted woman that met the Savior of the world. Lord, I'm thankful that I met him.
Such an awesome story in the Scripture. How that Jesus said, I must needs go through Samaria. The Jews had no dealings with the Samaritans. They avoided each other, but Jesus said, I got to go through Samaria. You see, Samaria was in trouble. They were away from God, and Jesus was wanting to win them back. And so he said, I got to go through Samaria. And I think one of the most amazing parts of that story, and there's a lot of them, was that Jesus was trying to reach a city or maybe a nation. He didn't go to the dignitaries. He didn't go to the president or the prime minister, but he went to a sinner woman that was in trouble. Oh, she had came down to the well to draw water, and Jesus stopped by that well. He made a trip through Samaria for that one woman because he knew she can change her neighborhood. She can change her family. She can change her nation. I don't know who we're talking to right now, but God's calling some of you to win your families, to win your communities, to make a difference where you live at tonight. You may feel like that woman at the well, that you can't even love yourself. She'd had five husbands, and the one she had now wasn't her own. But Jesus loved her, and he said, if you just ask me, I'll give you a drink of this living water. It'll be in you a well of water springing up into everlasting life. And the Bible said, she said, sir, give me this water that I thirst no more. Hallelujah. He'll set you free tonight, no matter where you've been, who you've been running with. If you'll call out on Jesus, he'll set you free tonight. I want Daniel, if he will, to sing that song. It's one of his favorites, because you don't have to go riding on that long black train. You don't have to be lost. Amen. But you can make it to heaven. Come on, son.
I want to send this out to my good buddy Tony Sizemore, Kevin Maggard, Miss Annie Thompson, if they're watching tonight. And, you know, I love this song. This is one I get requested a lot. It's the first song I ever sung in church. And I just love it. And there's a good meaning behind it. And, you know, we're not up here as a platform to build names for ourselves or for our church. But I heard the other night people were calling in and saying that this is their church, like Dad said. So we're here tonight to have church with you at home, because it's just us. There's no crowd here. We're doing this for you at home. So I hope that this song touches somebody tonight. There's a long black train. Oh,
but you know there's victory.
Josh, you ready to sing? Amen. God is good.
I want to send this out to my mother-in-law and my husband and son and Brenda and Danny. He's God on the platform.
God everywhere. Hallelujah. Ethan, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Hey, man, I believe Ethan is ready.
Bless me how it is that I'm still standing. You wonder how I made it through the storm. I can boast of any special powers. There's no secret, I just the things were finally happening. I've got blessings I can call my own. Many times I wondered if I would make it, but while I was wondering, I just kept holding.
Presence of the Lord. I believe that there's somebody right now that you're right at your breaking point. But I want to tell somebody tonight, just hold on a little bit longer. Just hold on. I believe there's somebody watching tonight that you may even been praying today that you would just die and get on out of here. But I want to tell you tonight, hold on just a little bit longer. Amen. I feel the presence of the Lord touching somebody right now. There's a better time coming. Hallelujah. Amen. Mama, won't you sing that song? There's going to be a time no burdens will pass through. Hallelujah. Man, there's going to be a day after a while. It'll all be over. There's going to be a day, amen, when we're going to rejoice forevermore and be with the Lord. Hallelujah. Hold on. Sometimes you don't know what else to do. Just hold on. Amen. Hold on to God. Keep on praying. Man, look up, your redemption draweth nigh tonight. Amen. Sing it, Mama.
No storm clouds arise, no light in the sky, and my loved ones are waiting for me. There's glory divine.
place.
For this song, and I guess we better do it tonight. Don't want to get in trouble. Amen. Not for sale. You got to have a made up mind that you're going to go all the way with the Lord. The devil's after you. He'll try his best to talk you out of serving God. And so you just got to say, devil, I'm not for sale. Amen. And we're going to try it out tonight. Amen.
What happened to that preacher who used to preach so strong? What happened to that singer who used to sing God's song? Preachers out selling Amway, singers out singing country. They sold out what is right for what is wrong. What happened to that church that used to be on fire? What happened to all the voices that sing in that heavenly choir? Church is now grown dead and cold. The choir is silent, 'cause nobody goes. They sold out to the world and their own desire. But this heart belongs to Jesus, 'cause he saved my soul from hell. This heart belongs to Jesus, and this heart, not for sale.
Not for sale.
Not for sale. California called a few months ago. He said, "Borrow your talent, we could make a lot of dough." I said, "Thanks for your offer, it all sounds so well, but I belong to Jesus and devil, I'm not for sale.
Not for sale.
Not for sale.
Not for sale.
Not for sale. If you're living for Jesus, then there'll come a day that old devil's gonna try and get you some way. Well, he'll try you and he'll tempt you with his lies straight from hell to say, I belong to Jesus, and devil, I'm not for sale.
Not for sale.
Not for for sale.
Not for sale.
Not for sale.
Not for sale.
No way, no, sir. Not for sale. You see, you got to have a made up mind. There's a lot of things in our world today that's pulling, trying to pull us away from God. Amen, but you got to decide now, I'm going to live for God. Amen, I'm going to let the world go by because I want to stand for what is right. Amen, I'm not trying to be popular in my community. Amen, I'm not trying to move up in my political party. Amen, I just want to serve God. I remember there was a sweet lady many years ago that was singing, and my, she could sing heaven down. And they called her one time out of Nashville and offered her a recording contract. And you know what she replied to them? She said, I just want to be where God's people is. Amen, that's where my happiest times are. Amen, is when I'm with God's people. Knowing that I'm ready for heaven. Honey, don't you sell out on God tonight. I've seen men over the years that they sold out for another overtime shift at work. They'd rather be working than to be in the house of God. I've seen them give up going to the house of God to become popular in politics. Honey, I'm going to tell you something. There ain't nothing in this world worth losing your soul over. Amen. But the Bible said, what is a man profited if he should gain the whole world and lose his own soul? What would a man give in exchange for his soul? You think about that tonight. The Bible says that we have been redeemed, not with corruptible things such as silver and gold, but by the precious blood of Jesus. Oh my, you're valuable in the eyes of God tonight. I read a statistic the other night that it was the federal government, one of their sites that valued human life, and they come up with a number, 9 different studies, and they said that a human life is worth $9 million. $9 million. Well, that's pretty good for some folk, but for others, they're not even worth the salt goes into cornbread. But in the eyes of God, you see, God said, if you lose your soul, silver and gold can't buy it back. The only thing is the blood of Jesus. What can wash away all sin? It's nothing but the blood of Jesus. This heart belongs to Jesus, 'cause he saved my soul from hell. That's the reason I serve him. He reached way below the bottom, brought me out. This heart belongs to Jesus, 'cause he saved my soul from hell. And this heart belongs to Jesus. And this heart, not for sale.
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 Not for sale. No way, no, sir. Not for sale.
Thank God, thank God. Amen. Sister Margaret.
Well, song, it's a wonderful message. And you know, where Jesus told us over and over to not let anyone deceive us, and in the last day, because that evil was be so strong, the love of many would wax cold. And so that's like the song says, you can't lose your soul. For years I have said there was not anyone or anything here worth you losing your soul for. And so tonight we're so glad to have the 11th Hour Ministries, and each Sunday evening at
5:30.
You can join in their church with them. They have their church service, and they have a good service, and they bring it right our way. So that is the marvel of Christian TV.
It is.
You can get the message out and not even have to leave your home, because so many you know, are not able to leave. And so we have a number of requests in here, and we want to try to get to as many as we can. We want you to pray for the family of Dennis Levins. He passed away this afternoon at the UK hospital, and the funeral arrangements are incomplete right now, but be sure and pray for the family. And his wife is not well, and so the whole family needs help. And then also Emily Estes had a possible stroke this evening, and thank you, Edith. So there's a lot of folk that are in need of prayer right now.
Yes, sir,
yes. Let's see. Do you want to try to read some of these?
I sure will.
Okay. Let's see. There's some that we'll get as many as we can in. Here's one from Georgetown. Nancy said she's glad to see me back, and well, it's good to be back. The last 3 months have been kind of rough, but the Lord's brought us through. Perry County family with COVID. Stella Day from Fort Wayne, Indiana has called for herself and her friend Jerry, and also Stella is going to help the ministry here by sending in a gift of $220. Thank you so much. Amen. Stella Day from Fort Wayne, Indiana. And so remember their prayer request and needs. Kimberly from Lexington, sinus infection, and Terry's family from Estill County. And also yesterday, I missed them, but Liz Couch, a good friend that we've had for a long time, her daughter came by the station here, and I missed them, but Liz used to come and help answer phones, and now she's unable to, but she watches all the time, so she sent me a Christmas present. Thank you, Liz, and I'm going to get on the phone to you as soon as I can. But Liz has always been a good friend. She's helped the minister a lot, and so it's good to hear from her. You want to read some of those now?
All right. Here is Linda's asking prayer for her mother, and so I believe it says Florida. But test results proved all is well. Thank you, Jesus. Mm-hmm. Betty Wells from Menifee needs prayer this evening with cancer. Here's a daughter and a mother from Floyd County, pain in the legs. Here's an unspoken request. Pray for son and for grandchildren. Here's prayer for a daughter-in-law and a son that has COVID. Here's Reverend Eugene Baker needing prayer this evening from Perry County. We're praying for Brother Eugene Baker. Here's from Perry County, Barbara Griffith. Please be in prayer for her. Has had surgery 3 times in her leg, and it's not healing. Here's Linda from Laurel needs prayer. From Madison County, looks like Denise Morgan and family. I believe they have cancer and is really sick. From Hazard, Leona Collins, blood clot in her legs and needs prayer. Here from Wolf County, Paul, he says his wife has a broken hip, and him and her both need prayer. Here's from Hazard, for Morris and White family. I believe I'm reading that right. Morris and White family. Please be praying for them. Here's, you'll just have to stop me now.
Okay, well, we're We're watching the time.
All right. From Morgan County. Alfie, I believe is the name. Mm-hmm. Alfie has COVID, needs prayer. From Johnson County, husband called in for his wife that has health issues. From Casey County, a mother's called in for her son with pneumonia. Juanita from Wolf County has health problems. Tony Hobson from Powell, can't sleep, needs prayer. Phyllis and Mickey from Laurel, they have health problems and they need a touch. Here's an unspoken request from Letcher County. And just so many of them, Sister
Martin. Yeah, there is. I read these. We will just have to pray for them all together. A lot of them have COVID. Yeah, this thing is not going away. I tell you, we need to see a miracle from the Lord.
Yes,
on,
we do.
On this. And so let's pray. So many people. It's taken so many lives. And go ahead.
All right. Will you join me as we pray this evening? Yes. Heavenly Father, God, we believe in the power of prayer.
Yes, Lord.
Your word declares that two of us agree and in touching any one thing that it shall be done. God, you know every need that's written down here on these papers tonight, God, and we're asking you to touch each and every one. Father, I believe that by those stripes that you bore on your back, that was for our healing. And Father, we're believing right now in the name of Jesus that you're going to touch these folk. God, by faith we ask it, by faith we believe it, and by faith we call it done.
Yes.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Yes.
Amen, amen.
Amen, that's so good. We appreciate appreciate Brother Terry and his church for being here. How's the church doing during this?
It's been doing pretty good. We've had a lot of families that have been affected by COVID, and my family as well. But thank God we've survived, and
okay.
We came through it. But we're starting to do a little better now.
Oh, good. So, well, any announcements? You got anything going on at the church you want to mention?
Coming up, which is next month, on March 27th, we're going to have a big mission service. Brother Fred Nguyen, he's missions to Asia. He'll be joining us in March, and we've got some other things, but we don't have the dates worked out. But we'd love for you to come be with us at 59 East Main Street, Hazard, Kentucky, Sunday morning beginning at 10:30, Tuesday night at 7.
Mm-hmm. All right. And the phone number there is 606-439-4988. Get in touch with them, and join a group that's winning souls for the Lord. Looks like we are out of time, so we appreciate all of you being with us and appreciate this church for coming and sharing tonight. So from all of us, we want to say good night and God bless you.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope that you are truly blessed and encouraged every time you watch. This program is made possible by your contribution and support. Would you become a financial partner of the Hour of Harvest with a one-time or monthly offering? You can send your pledges of support to the Hour of Harvest, Post Office Box Y, Bayville, Kentucky, 41311, or visit us online at www.hourofharvest.com. May God bless you.